Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, my dear brothers and sisters on DOPStv. I wanted to speak to you about getting ready for Ramadan, mashallah. So this is going to be a different Ramadan. Everything that you know about Ramadan is changed now, subhanallah. Open houses that you Malaysians, you crazy Malaysians, mashallah, open houses till 3 a.m., mashallah. Makan, day and night is not going to be happening as it used to last year. And subhanAllah, the open houses for Eid and many of these other things, we're going to have to reconsider our Ramadan and the giving that we have and the connecting with our families and the things that we normally love to do. So how do we make our Ramadan productive, active, holistic, spiritual, full of khair, full of happiness, full of connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? So three things that I want to highlight with you today, inshallah. One is, being alone does not mean being lonely. And being alone or having what is referred to as wahsha in Islamic Arabic vernacular is not something that was unknown to the Prophet or the Prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So to have moments where you focus on yourself, connect with yourself, build yourself, analyze, account, think about what you want for the future and how you're going to achieve it, is actually a very powerful sunnah that all of the prophets of Allah endured. So think about Bani Israel, 40 years in isolation in the desert, traveling around until they reconnected with Allah. Think about Yusuf alayhi salam, who was trapped in that prison unjustly, bid'u sinin, until he was ransomed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think of our Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who would sit in the cave until the Tawheed was revealed and the Quran was brought down. Think of Ibrahim alayhi salam, who was expelled by his father and mother and people and family from his city and was ordered to leave. فَإِن لَمْ تَنْتَهِ لَأَرْجُمَنَّكَ وَهْجُرْنِي مَلِيَهْجُرْنِي, leave me, we don't want to see your face again. Think about Israel, or who's Prophet Yaqub. Why is that his nickname? Israel, Asra Lillah. He traveled secretly by night to escape by the order of Allah. Think of all of the messengers, all of the prophets. Think of Isa alayhi salam and Maryam having to sneak out of Bayt al-Maqdis and Jerusalem so that she could save Jesus alayhi salam as a young child from being marked by the sinful, fraudulent religious authority. So think about all of them and you'll find that all of them had moments where they were on a journey or in a place of isolation to reconnect themselves with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Have that as something in your mind when you find yourself that you're not able to do the same things you do, and count it in your intention as an act of worship. So when you stay at home, it's actually an act of worship. It's an act of worship that, oh Allah, I'm staying at home because I'm following what I've been ordered to do by our governmental authorities. But it's also an act of worship because this is something that will improve me and help me focus on the things that I need to improve in. I hope, inshallah, that this was of help to you. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Your brother Yahya Ibrahim on DOPStv.